Good day to all of you. So now you have completed the Writer 1 course. In Writer 1, you have learned about the basic information of Writer like menu bar, standard bar, formatting bar, ruler, status bar, etc. Now you will be learning further about Writer. The portion of Writer 2 that we will learn about in this session is from the view menu to format menu. Before we begin today's lesson, let us revise about Writer 1. Do you all remember what was taught to you in Writer 1? In the last part, you learned about some important aspects of Writer like saving a file, opening a file, save as option, export as PDF, undo, redo, cut, paste, find and replace, etc. Can you tell why the formatting toolbar is used? By using the formatting toolbar, we can format any text or paragraph and make desired changes to the font color, to the size of the font, making the text bold, underlined, or italics, etc. Can you tell what happens with export as PDF and what is the full form of PDF? By using export as PDF, you can convert your Writer file to PDF format. PDF format is such that no one can edit our file, which means that no one can write in our file or delete anything from our file. Such a file can only be read. And the full form of PDF is Portable Document Format. Can you tell why we use Find and Replace? By using Find, we can find any text or word in our document, and by using replace, we can then change the same. All of you should now go ahead and power on your computer and open the Writer file. If you face any problems in doing this, you should watch the video and take its help to open your file. You can open the Writer file in many ways. Today you will learn a new method of opening the Writer document. This method is the shortcut command method. To open a file with a shortcut command, you must know the command for that opening. So first of all, you need to keep your left hand one finger on the Windows key and press the R key. Watch in the video. The Windows key is shown. Press it with the left hand and press the R button. A box opens, which is the run window. In this, you have to, without giving any spaces, type out S Writer. S-W-R-I-T-E-R, and then take the cursor or the pointer to the OK button and click on OK. Your Writer document will open. In today's class, you will learn about the view submenu. Let us now learn why we use the view submenu. The view option helps you to show or hide the options which you want to keep on your Writer page, like text boundaries, ruler, status bar, formatting toolbar, drawing, and any other options that you want to show or hide on your page using the view option. Look at the paragraph given in front of you and start typing it on your Writer page. Within the view menu, we will first learn about print layout or web layout. Do you know the difference between print layout and web layout? With print layout, you can see your page in a normal view, and this also shows all your pages. In web layout, you can see all the pages in one page itself. Let us understand this further by watching the video and learn about using the print layout and the web layout. In this video, we learn about the print layout and the web layout. You notice that in the video being shown to you, your page is in the print layout. So, in this case, both your pages are appearing on the screen as you can see in the video. Now, if you want to change this to web layout, you have to go to view menu and press on the web layout. Here you will only be able to see one page in the entire screen. If you want to bring it back to page layout, print layout, you have to go to view and select or click on the print layout menu. Next, you will learn about the toolbar. Can you tell why we use the toolbar? The toolbar is a shortcut method by using which you can do your work more easily. Let us watch the video to learn how we can show or hide the toolbar. With the help of this video, we will learn how we can use the view menu to hide or show our toolbars. So, to hide the toolbars, take your pointer or cursor to the view option and click on it. As is being shown in the video, a box opens. Come to the toolbars option and you will see another box opening. Now, when you come to the drawing option and click on it, you will notice that your drawing toolbar, which is at the bottom of your screen, has disappeared or has been hidden. Again, take your pointer to the view option and click on that and come to the toolbars option, and within the box which opens, select the formatting toolbar option, and you will notice that your formatting toolbar has also been hidden. Next, we go back again to the view option, go to the toolbars option and click on the standard option, and you will notice that your standard toolbar also gets hidden. Now, let's learn how we can bring them back. We go to the view option, go to toolbars and select the drawing option, and you will notice that at the bottom of your screen, the drawing toolbar will reappear. Again, go to the view option, select the toolbars, and then select the formatting option, and you will notice that your formatting toolbar reappears. Once again, if you go to the view option, click on the toolbars, and now click on standard. This is to bring back the standard toolbar. In case it does not appear, you can just take your pointer or cursor to the formatting toolbar on the left side and click on that and move up or down your toolbar, and you will notice that the standard toolbar also reappears. Now, you will learn about status bar. Can you tell why we use the status bar? Status bar tells us about the status of the page and lets us know which page you are on, which language is selected, and how much you have zoomed. As you are already aware, the status bar appears in the lower portion of the writer page. Learn about how you can hide or unhide the status bar by watching the video. Let us now see in this video how we can hide and unhide the status bar. The status bar appears at the bottom of your screen. So to hide the status bar, take your pointer or cursor to the view menu, press with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and then select or click on the status bar option. As soon as you click, you will notice that your status bar gets hidden from the bottom. Now, if you want to bring back the status bar, you have to bring your pointer or cursor back to the view option and once again click on the status bar option and your status bar reappears. So, this is how you can hide or unhide the status bar. Let us now learn how to hide or show the ruler bar. Do you know what is ruler? And how many types of ruler are there? Ruler helps in setting up margins in the page. It also helps the user to set the line or paragraph as per the user's convenience. There are two types of rulers in Writer, horizontal ruler and vertical ruler. Now, all of you will learn how to hide or show the ruler by watching this video. This video will help us to learn how we can hide or show the ruler on our Writer page. To hide or show the ruler, we need to take our pointer or cursor to the view menu, click on that, and a submenu box opens. Click on the ruler option and you will see, as is being shown in the video, that the rulers of your Writer page have got hidden. Now, if you want to show the rulers again, you have to again bring the pointer to the view option, left click on that, and then from the options click on ruler again and the rulers will reappear or will be shown. Now you will learn about how to show or hide text boundaries. Now you may be wondering, what is text boundary? In Writer, there are lines on all four sides of the page that you work on. These are called text boundaries. You can type only within these text boundaries and not outside them. Now, you will learn how you can hide or unhide the text boundaries by watching the video. In this video, we will learn how to hide or unhide the text boundaries on our Writer page. To do this, bring your pointer or the cursor to the view option of the menu bar, left click with the mouse or the touchpad, and then click on the text boundary option. As soon as you click there, you will notice that the text boundaries get hidden on the Writer page. Now, if you want to bring them back, you have to again go to the view option of the menu bar, take your pointer there, as is being shown in the video, left click on that and then click on the text boundaries option and you will notice that your text boundaries on the Writer page are shown again. Next, you will learn about non-printing characters. These are a type of special symbols. These symbols show the characters which we cannot print, like space and enter being used for new line. Non-printing characters show these symbols and that is why we call them non-printing characters. Let us now learn how to hide or show such non-printing characters. This video will help us to learn how to show or hide non-printing characters on our Writer page. To do this, we have to take our pointer or the cursor to the view menu of the menu bar and left click with our mouse or touchpad as is being shown in the video, and then from the submenus click on the non-printing characters option with the left button. Once you click there, you will notice that the non-printing symbols appear on your writer page. Now again, if you want to hide these non-printing symbols, you will take the pointer or the cursor to the view menu of the menu bar, click there, and then click on the non-printing characters option, and you will see that the symbols get hidden. Next, you will all learn about full screen. By using this option, the page screen becomes as big as the computer screen, and all your writer options get hidden. The shortcut command for this is Ctrl plus Shift plus J. Let us watch the video and learn how we use this. This video shows us how we can show our writer page on full screen. To do this, to take the writer page to full screen, go to the view option on the menu bar and then left click there, and from the submenu box which opens, click on the full screen option. It is being shown to you in the video. When you click here, you will see that your writer page appears in the full screen. In this case, the format bar, the status bar, etc. get hidden. Now, if you want to bring back all those things which have got hidden, you have to come to this full screen button and click there with the left button of the mouse or touchpad, and it becomes normal. Now you will learn the use of zoom. By using zoom, we can increase or decrease the size of your page. Zoom can be used in two ways, which are being shown in the video. You can zoom your writer page in two ways, which are being shown to you in this video. In the first way, we take our pointer to the view option of the menu bar, and with our pointer, with our mouse or the touchpad, left button, we click on that, and from the options shown in the option window, click on zoom. Another box opens, click on variable, and now if you click on the up arrow here, the page size increases, but if you click on the down arrow, the page size decreases. So once you have selected, click on OK and your page zooms to that size. Another way of doing it is by bringing the cursor here, and if you press on the plus sign, the page size increases. If you press on the minus sign, the page size decreases, as is being shown in the video to you. And now, since we will be ending today's lesson here, you should close your writer files. If you face any problems, then learn from the video. In order to close the writer file, so take your pointer or the cursor to the top right corner where there is a cross sign and click on that with the mouse or the touchpad using the left button. You see three options appearing in a window. Since you do not want to save right now, you can say discard, which is the middle option. Click on that with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and your file, writer file, gets closed. Next, go ahead and properly shut down your systems. In today's class, you have learned all the options of the view submenu and have also had a chance to practice their use. You have learned about the differences in print layout and web layout, how to show or hide the toolbar, how to hide or show the status bar, and lastly about how Zoom is used. Thank you.